don't think there's a rapper that's out right now that I feel like I'm not in the same ballpark with. Period. What it is, what it was, what it looked like. You see it on me, but it look tight. See, I look right, and I look left. But I'm the only one that seems to look fresh.
This is the group's third album.
Yeah.
And I'm just wondering if it feels like that to you as a third album, and is the group where you thought you'd be, you know, at this point? What's the approach with a new Kidz In The Hall album? It almost seems like each new one is like a new starting point.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like we've caught a lot of flack and we've caught a lot of praise for the exact same things. Like sometimes people are like, we're too scatterbrained and we're too eclectic and we never just pick one style all the way through, or we just change everything up every time we come out. People don't like that, it doesn't feel genuine to them. But then other people have praised us for that, and they're like, it seems that genuine that they just make what they feel. They don't try to make it fit within a certain particular box. Like, a lot of people told us, like, don't put Driving Down a Blockout because it sounds like a Cool Kids record. Like, I'll be flat out honest, like, a lot of people were like, don't put that out. But I'm like, yo, how can you tell me that when I played it for the Cool Kids and they said it's a dope record and they honored it and wanted to get on it? You know what I'm saying? Like, but they're like, no, but marketing-wise, it'll cause confusion between, it's like, that's not how I operate. We've never operated in that manner where we feel like we can't touch upon a topic or we can't make a certain type of song because, you know, it might not be good for our image. We just make what feels good and we make what we like. School's My Hustle was supposed to be a mixtape.
Okay.
That was just supposed to be in preparation for my solo album.
Right. Knowledge is Power.
Yeah,
right.
Which that was when we were still Rawkus.
Yep.
And a lot of people look at it like it's an album and like it really had the promotion. It's like, let's be real, I'll be real. Like, Rawkus didn't do shit. Like, I love Brian and Jared, but they didn't do shit for that album. We only shipped like 5,000 copies of that album. If you could find, that's why I was on Twitter, I said, if you could find a physical copy of that album in a store, I will buy you dinner. Anybody in Chicago, if you could find, right now, if you go to a store and find a physical copy of School's Monster, I will buy you dinner. And it won't be McDonald's and no goofy shit like that. I'll get you a real meal.
Real meal. You and Double O were the face, the my generation, my age champions, our Mos Def or Talib Kweli or what have you. Do you think that some people still have that? That's the Kidz In The Hall they know still, and you're fighting to break that with that, and then with that shift, and now a lot of the new artists that have come out just come, like, very fast and completely different.
I felt like people mispegged us from the jump. Like, people assumed just because it was Rawkus that what they were trying to do was bring back this Black Star Reflection Eternal stuff, when in reality the point was to give a new spin on what they had always done, which is do cutting edge hip hop shit. And the new cutting edge hip hop shit was basically what we were doing back in 06, and that's what, if you listen to School's My Hustle, like, it's cutting edge hip hop. Like, it's not necessarily super duper duper backpack. It was a point at time where I think we were just so happy to be there.
Right.
We were so happy that these industry veterans, and right, we were meeting so many people who we looked up to, were telling us that we were dope, and we put everything into their hands. We said, hey, take care of us. And it didn't happen. You know what I mean? We sat around for about a year. We realized they weren't trying to put my solo record out. So we started working on a mixtape. And Mighty My from High and Mighty was going to put it out. And what happened is they decided to put it out as an album. It got good reviews. Then once it got good reviews, they decided to make it look a little bit bigger than what it really was, which is why people perceive it to be an album when that's not really how we intended it. To me, in my heart of hearts, like, the In Crowd was our first album. Like, it was the first time we went into the studio and said, hey, let's make an album that's gonna be presented the way we want it to be presented. We worked with all the people we wanted to work with, who are all our friends. We did not, like, people ask me how we got certain people on the album. They are our friends.
Right.
Over the years, we've met a lot of people just being in this industry, and we respect them and they respect us, and we just try to make dope art.
Yep.
And that's kind of what we wanted to accomplish with the In Crowd. And we did that, and it felt good because it let us know that our instincts were right. And I feel like we put an album out at a time where the major labels were just starting to pluck up a lot of our friends and kind of push this quote unquote hipster rap shit.
Exactly. So what do you think of that when you see the top artists are young guys that at a year or 2 years ago
they was opening.
Yeah, they were opening. It was like the cool. It was the Kidz In The Hall headlining showcase with Mickey Fax and the Cool Kids and all. Had the pack dibs and all that.
I had just met, like
Cuddy, all that.
If you watch the Driving Down the Block video, Donis is in that video, Pac Dibs in that video. If you really look closely, you know what I'm saying? If you watch the Love Hangover video, it's a lot of cats. This, you know what I'm saying? Like, we met you and I back then. We met a lot of people back then. Asher Roth, we met a lot of these people, you know, way back. And they were fans of ours, you know what I mean? And we have respect, we always had respect for them. It's just, we've seen them grow exponentially by taking the format that we all were using, the internet, the blog sites, the iTunes, direct to digital, because we knew that that's what the wave of the future was. We knew that's how we would reach our fan base, was to talk directly to the fans and to take everything out of the label's hands and make it ours. This is stuff we were doing. We were in 10D's lookbook, you know what I'm saying, like 2 years ago.
Right, so.
And now the 10 Deep mixtape is the way you get your deal. You know what I'm saying? Like, these are things we were doing. So when I say I'm happy with where we are, I'm not satisfied, but I'm happy.
Okay.
But I know that with this new shit we're doing, I feel like we're the underdog. To me, this is the second album.
Okay.
To me, this, it feels more like a sophomore album. It doesn't feel like a freshman album. I mean, a junior album or whatever. It feels like if people like this new stuff, then we'll finally be over this hump.
So at what point did you decide to not go with the winner circle and that whole thing and go with the Land of Make Believe? And just based on the title, it seems like it might be a continuing theme from Love Hangover and what you were talking about.
You know what? The winner circle was kind of like, it was kind of our thought process of like, okay, we're with the in crowd. We're kind of listed amongst those who were supposed to be next. And the winner's circle is getting over the hump.
Yeah.
But then we were like, we don't want to appear like cocky, like it's already happened. What people want to, people don't want to know about the job they have, they want to know about the job they want.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, people want to speak things into existence. People want to live, fake it until you make it. This shit is like the Land of Make Believe. It's an inspirational album, like, that's how I look at it. Like, it's motivational speaking. Like, yeah, we've done some shit, but these songs make you feel like doing more shit. You know what I mean? It makes you wanna aspire to be greater, and once you become great, to be legendary. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't settle for just being good or being okay or just having a couple people like your shit. Like, there's nothing wrong with saying, like, y'all wanna do arenas.
Is there a lot kind of riding on the success? Do you have plans that certain things need to happen with this album to get Kidz In The Hall, like your vision?
I don't like to think about those types of things. I just want to progress like artistically,
okay,
and have people really fuck with the music and really feel the music. Because there's nothing better than doing a live show and have people know the records and feel the records and come up to you after the show. Like, that's what we do it for. That's all I want to accomplish with this album, is doing more shows and getting out to more fans and reaching more people. So with every album, it's like another submission to the public of why they should support us.
Okay.
So it's like the money that you put into buying our record, whether it's on iTunes or it's in a store, it's just telling the label that they should keep supporting our artistic endeavors. Then we go to your city, do the show, and that's when you can show us the real love by being there, wilding the fuck out. And that's what feeds us, and that's what gives us the energy to go make more dope shit. Like, that's really all we want to do. So we just want to keep making authentic music. My thing is, you don't have to like me as a person. I'm just a vessel to provide art. You know what I'm saying? If you like the art, you can like the art separate from liking Jabari Evans. You don't gotta like me. You know what I'm saying? But you can play my music.
but ain't here no more. Coast to the rest of the queer pro quo. To the nest that they hear so dope. Note that the flow that they hear no joke. Timeless, fly as the lid won't go. Highest, higher than the mile high smoke. Wired, wallow in the pal I choke. Just another California night with my Westwood red bone call a night light. Lighting up the turnpike with a skirt hike. Daddy put it down like a touchdown spike. She's so gone.